from Nova Scotia, William MacPherson Brewer.
Hello, hello. Hello, America. Hello. Hello, Europe. Anyone from Greece, have a shout out. In Canada, my hometown, my home country. And there's a place in Canada where I was born, and I want to mention that I am originally from Fredericton, New Brunswick. And those who I haven't mentioned, I will get to you, but this is my story. Let's just say 27 years ago when I was born, I was diagnosed with trisomy 21, and I am proud of it. And I also want to just say hello to a star in the audience tonight. And if I don't say your name, you are on my list of names. I am so privileged and honored to be talking to all the chapters, students, volunteers, and BBLC Inclusion Revolution staff, and everyone else. I want to thank everyone for hearing me, including my hometown, Fredericton. And I wanted to say thank you for talking to me, getting to know me, and as well as getting to know my stories. And I'm so proud in being here, from all the way from Nova Scotia, which I traveled with two other chiquitas, I would say. And I want to mention by name, Kelsey and Catherine. The interesting fact about me is that, in my own opinion, is style and flair are important. And I'm not just talking about my Tom Cruise look. With the hair and sunglasses, of course. All that aside, a couple of years ago, in Canada, I joined up with a Down syndrome group, which is called the Nova Scotia Down Syndrome Society. And I have been in two programs called Friday Night Socials and Team Possibles, and what the leader there told me about best buddies. And I'm so proud in getting to know all the chapters here tonight. And I also want to encourage all of us, including myself, and all of you from all your chapters, and be a strong chapter at it, because all you can do your best at your own school. And I know you can do your best, and I want to encourage it. And thank you for the chapters who told me stories about them that I will, and gave me some paraphernalia that I can bring back to Canada. All right, when I was a kid, when I went to daycare, one of the daycares was full, but because my brother was the last one, and his name was Oliver in Halifax at Cole Harbour. And that I couldn't get in, but when they found out I was Down syndrome, I got in. So, in Canada, people with, and this is the topic today, is that I'd like to bring to you, is that people have Down syndrome and disabilities. And I also want to advocate others on behalf of in the communities, colleges, where I'm from is called universities. Also high schools and middle schools. So everyone can have a program where they can belong to, such as art, any type of program you want to be with, especially with Best Buddies, because and they helped me. In Canada, people with disabilities are a minority, and people with Down syndrome are a hidden minority. And I am sad because we don't have a name in our Canadian Human Rights Act, and I want that. And because Down syndrome is important to my community, that my buddy Jillian inspired me to also to meet other communities because I was so welcomed by her that I was welcome to all of you. I found a couple of quotes that I believe can express my message. The first one is by Harold R. McLinden. Thanks to my instructor today. He gave me these cool quotes that I want to share with you. Do not follow where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path and leave a trail. The second one is by John Quincy Adams. If your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more, you are a leader, like all of you are here tonight and this weekend. And when I was a kid in middle school, or it could have been elementary or middle, if I can remember, I was segregated within the school. And after every class, we and other kids who were disabled, actually, I'm gonna take the diss of disabled and say all abilities. And we would go in our own room where we have no contact with our friends, who they were integrated, and we couldn't go see them, which was sad for me, because we had to have lunch in our own room. And it was a program room for people like us, like the R word, and I don't like that at all. And I have never been called that, and I was never bullied, so I'm happy that I've never been those things. I hope people who have intellectual disabilities, special needs, and Down syndrome of all ages can be integrated in all school systems. So, like I said about my style, like Tom Cruise, I want to use my style and flair, but not just my hair, to leave my own trail and leave something behind so that people with Down syndrome have a voice within their community. One time years ago, the Canadian Council on Rehabilitation at Work had interviewed me to get me into that program, and they had asked me what my disability was. Well, guess what I told them? I am Will! I have Down syndrome! Like, besides the art community that I've told you about with back in Canada, also another group has helped me. All of you did. Because you inspired me to become a leader and an ambassador that I want to, when I get back home, I'm going to really advocate with people with, not just with disabilities, but as well with Down syndrome. So So, and like I'm a, and I'll, and but like I said, like I am affiliated with other programs in Canada, and the buddy director who was there selected me, part of Mount St. Vincent University, all the way in Canada, in Nova Scotia, left us this past Thursday with no message, no reason. I think she has been there for so long that two of my friends from Nova Scotia will know her name, Nicole McDonald. So when I get home, I am going to sign up for Toastmasters. Those who know Nova Scotia know who that program is, and I'm going to, and Toastmasters is the same thing as ambassadors, because I want to get more confidence in public speaking, like right now. And today, I had met an adorable young lady. And to end this, I would like to say that I am inspired by Lauren Potter, because I did get the chance to speak to her and tell her that she was an inspiration to the Down syndrome community, and I got a picture with her. All right. She advocated for Down syndrome community, and being an ambassador and advocating a lot, as well as being on the top hit show Glee, which is my favorite. But this weekend I wanted to treat her as a person, and I did today. And me being an ambassador, and she and I are alike besides having Down syndrome, because I like the theater and I want to advocate too. And I'm so honored in being an ambassador for Canada, for St. Mary's University of Nova Scotia, and thank you and all of you for being a friend. And I have learned this past weekend, those who may have actually listed their goals for your conference, because they have asked you to do your goals. Mine was to learn the cultures of the buddies and get to know each other and understand them. Many years ago, I went to a majestic place. It was full of beauty and gorgeous until I found a hotel in the park, which I did not really was happy about. And that was Argentina! And I have met her on Thursday at the pre-conference, and I'm so privileged to be her friend and to understand all of you and her. I love you too! And I love all of you. And I love being here in front of you all to talk to you about my story. Thank you very much.